You're watching UNICEF Television. Kir Demba, a small village almost 2 hours' drive from Senegal's capital, Dakar. It's health day. Outreach health workers have arrived to provide a basic package of healthcare services. Under one tree, babies are weighed and checked for signs of malnutrition or stunting. Under another, women learn about safe pregnancy and delivery practices through an educational board game. And under another, women are counseled on family planning. The health workers also dispense advice on diseases, vaccinations, and nutrition. The community approach allows them to reach women like Anta Nju, who, like many today, has brought her 4-month-old baby to the nearby Sampate Health Center for vaccinations against polio, diphtheria, tetanus, and hepatitis B.
I came to vaccinate my baby, so she'll be in better health and she'll grow up healthy.
Outreach efforts like these are vital for preventing illnesses, and UNICEF is assisting Senegal in the form of funding and technical support. Recently, Senegal was hard hit by a polio outbreak. There are currently 17 cases of the illness in the West African country. A countrywide campaign that aims to vaccinate 2.2 million children under 5 in Senegal is underway. UNICEF Executive Director Tony Lake, in Senegal for a global conference on girls' education and gender equality, visited the Sampate Health Center and spoke to health workers and women about the issues facing healthcare here. After an explanation on the community approach, Mr. Lake also visited the outreach projects in Kir Demba. He moved from tree to tree, speaking to women about health and access to information and facilities. He also handed out mosquito nets to mothers. Malaria is a major killer here.
We can't wait for health systems to work their way out from the centers while people are suffering in the communities. We have to be working in the communities as well. And it showed that there are very strong communities which can create local strong healthcare systems through community workers, but they need the delivery systems to get the vaccines and the other interventions out there.
In another village, down a dusty, rutted track, Mr. Lake met with Chief Demba Diawara. The chief, along with local women and Tostan, a UNICEF-supported NGO that uses a community empowerment program, has embarked on a crusade to end practices like female genital cutting and early forced marriage. He told Mr. Lake how he had walked from village to village, educating people about the dangers of FGC, while Uri Sal, a former cutter, told Mr. Lake about the girls she had seen who had physically suffered and often ended up in hospital. Mr. Lake applauded their resilience.
You are proof that the world can be changed, one community, and then two communities, and then four communities, and 400, and 4,000, and on and on.
As the afternoon sun baked the small village, women and children danced in celebration. UNICEF's executive director joined in, and then warmly bade them goodbye. He left thinking not about what UNICEF and health workers had taught the villagers, but about what the villagers had taught him. This is Guy Hubbard reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to www.unicef.org. Unite for Children.